Sparkle Squad, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Jasmine and welcome to my channel. So, I am really bored. As you guys probably already know, everything is closed, including the ice rink, so I can't even go skating and I really miss the ice and I just want to go skating again. But I'm stuck inside of my house and I haven't gone skating for over a week now and I really miss the ice. I just want to go back and I really want everything to be back to normal. But while I'm stuck in the house, I've been doing off ice and I've been watching a lot of figure skating movies. Most of them I'm just rewatching because I've seen almost every single figure skating movie you can think of. But it's the closest I can get to the ice, and I've also been reading a lot of figure skating articles, and I came across this really interesting article called Why Figure Skating is One of the Hardest Sports in the World, and I decided to share it with you guys. This article is titled Why Figure Skating is One of the Hardest Sports in the World, and it is written by Alex Rice, so let's start reading it. I'm sure some of you laughed at that title, but the men and women who have participated in this grueling sport understand it's the truth. I've been athletic my entire life. I've done soccer, basketball, softball, tennis, gymnastics, swimming, dance, field hockey, lacrosse, and figure skating. And I dedicated myself to all those sports. I can say, honestly, however, that figure skating is the hardest sport and therefore the most rewarding. While the stereotypical figure skating music is soft and slow and pretty, the people who compete with it are tough, fierce, and driven. How would you feel after skating triple sessions in one day and you still can't get the majority of jumps in your program? What about when there's a competition coming up and your coach is making you do double run-throughs? We want to yell in our coach's faces, but we can't get enough air back into our lungs to express how badly our legs are burning. So without further ado, here are four reasons figure skating is incredibly difficult. The first section is about blades. Our blades are 4 millimeters thick. 4 millimeters. We balance on very small metal edges as we fling our bodies into spins and jumps and footwork. It takes a lot of coordination and strength to stay standing as we go through our routines as opposed to running around on a field. Also, the smallest changes make the biggest differences. If you go too long without sharpening your blades, you won't be able to do your jumps or spins with the proper speed or height. If you go too long without getting new blades, they will flatten out and make it literally impossible to do any skills. While it's also important to get new sneakers or cleats for other athletes, using rundown equipment will not completely stop your ability to compete as it does with skating. The next section is about falls. The falls are painful and frequent. The only way to improve is to try new jumps and spins. The only way to learn those new skills is to try wholeheartedly. Nobody lands a double jump for the first time. If she doesn't really try to jump, when you really jump high and lose control, you fall hard on freezing cold ice, which is just as soft as pavement, and we don't use pads. I've had bruises on my knees, hips, tailbones, elbows, even shoulders. I've dislocated my shoulder and knee during skating. However, when you fall that hard, you have to just skate it off. You won't improve if you don't take the falls. But just imagine that time you took a tumble on public skate, that one time you went with some friends. You have to keep falling until you get better at gliding. but at least you're not flying into double-double combination jumps. The third section is flexibility. Personally, this is always the hardest part of this sport for me because I'm not naturally flexible. It is incredibly important, but not for the reason most of you are probably thinking of. It doesn't matter so much if you can't lift your leg over your head during a spin or a spiral. That skill is great for bonus points, but you have to be flexible enough to do the little things. For example, if my hip flexor is tight, I won't be able to take off vertically for my jumps, which could lead to some fantastic falls. If my hamstrings are tight, I won't be able to bend at the waist enough for a spin because it hurts too much. However, it's very difficult to stay flexible enough because your muscles get tight when you work out hard on the ice. So you need to stretch enough after every practice to make sure you can still do the skills. It's a relentless, difficult cycle. The fourth section is grace. While skating for 4 minutes straight and flinging your body into the air to do jump after jump and doing difficult footwork to get curricular points, you have to be present the entire time. You can't be hunchbacked with spaghetti arms as you skate. That presents a terrible image for the judges and audience. When you can barely breathe and you are frantically trying to stay calm for your next jump passage, you have to keep your shoulders down, have your arms out, and your head held high and your torso upright. It takes so much more strength to stand straight while doing these skills as opposed to just channeling that strength into getting up in the air. Try this right now. Keep your arms straight out from your body at shoulder length for 4 minutes straight. It's not as easy as it seems, so imagine doing that while going all over the ice. How on earth is this sport worth it? What insane people would put their bodies through the constant pain and humiliation and stress just to do a perfect program on the ice? The answer is the people who have felt the incredible satisfaction and pride in themselves when they finally get it right. It could take months, but when you're as stubborn as a skater, it eventually comes together and it's the most rewarding feeling in the world to finally land a jump on the toe or to nail that jump passage in the program. The sport only attracts the type of athletes who are willing to go through and back to do their passion and do it well. It therefore is not for the faint-hearted and should be recognized as one of the most difficult sports out there. That was the end of the article, and I can relate to everything that they said, and there are a lot of other things that make skating so hard. I especially relate to the part talking about that they've done a lot of many other sports because I've personally done gymnastics and ballet along with skating. And for me personally, this is totally just my opinion because every single sport has their own difficulties and ways that they are easy. But for me, figure skating is harder than gymnastics and ballet. But I mean, I can't really give my opinion on that because I never got that far in gymnastics and ballet, and I can barely do an aerial. But I know that gymnastics and ballet are both really hard because they have like flips off of the beam and like bar, and they have to like keep their toes pointed and nice and straight, and they are both really physical sports. So, but in my own opinion, figure skating is harder for me. This is the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I want you guys to comment down below if you guys agreed with this article or if you guys have a different idea of which sport is the hardest. I already told you guys that in my opinion it is figure skating, but I haven't tried out every single sport there is out there, so that is why I want to hear your guys' opinion of which sport is the hardest, and I want to hear your guys' opinion on why. Anyways, also don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on notifications. Love you guys! Bye!